It's the last day in zone one. I thought I was done with my front porch and my entryway, but as I sat here and looked around, I realized there are a few more things that I need to do, so let's get started. Welcome to This and That with Denise Jordan. I teach women how to make wise home health and beauty decisions so there's less chaos in their homes, they lead healthier lives, and they feel beautiful from the inside out. And today's chaos, I'm tackling the entryway. I'm actually finishing up zone one. Today is Saturday, and it's the last day of zone one. Zone one kind of started in the middle of the week, so we had like Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday to work on zone one. And today is that last day. And I decided that one of the things that I did need to do is do some dusting and sweep my steps and put out some fall decorations. I've already got one little planter in the corner that already has some fall colors, but I really want to just spice it up a little bit. I want to add some pumpkin spice or cinnamon spice embellishments, just to kind of make it smell really fall-like and make you think of Thanksgiving when you walk in my front door. I am feeling really, really good today. I mean, it's 10 o'clock in the morning. I've already worked out. I've even had time to get my face on, and I've had my purple smoothie, and I'm ready to get my zone cleaning done. I am working the Flylady cleaning process, and I've already got my morning routine done. So I've done my swish and swipe, I've unloaded my dishwasher, and now I'm going to do my zone cleaning. So I'm going to get this entryway done up, and there's a few things that I need to do on the back patio. Technically, that's not part of zone one, but it is November, and after today, it doesn't look like it's going to be weather-wise any time for me to do anything on the back patio, and there's just a few things I need to do. My husband's been working out there all week, so I just need to take care of a few things that he leaves for me to do, because he knows if he throws away any of the pots that I want to keep, he's in big trouble. So I'm going to take care of some of that today. But other than that, my zone one is looking pretty darn good.
Thank you.
these have such a great fragrance. It's a pumpkin spice fragrance, and it really says Thanksgiving and fall. So I wanted to just kind of fill this little cup with some of these. And I'll sit it under there where it lives. And I'll take the lid off that. And I'll even put a few of these inside here. Just tuck them down inside so they can just add a little fragrance to the entryway. You can't really see them, but hopefully you'll be able to smell them. My husband put this picture here of the two of us from our last vacation, so I gotta make sure I keep that there. We were in Los Cabos, Mexico. And then I'm gonna take the lid off of this little candle because it has a really good pumpkin spice fragrance as well. So. There. These are cinnamon flavored or cinnamon spiced pine cones, and they just really complement that pumpkin spice. Dyson cordless motor vac V8. I guess if I keep saying it enough, I'll get one. I've certainly put it on my Christmas list. want to dice in. This little Bissell light sweet is very nice. My husband bought it for me. It works fine. But as you can see, it's got a cord. The cord is always getting tangled up. But other than that, it works just fine. So since it is November, and one of the things that I'm trying to do is count my blessings, I am going to count the blessing that I do have this nice little lightweight sweeper to do my zone cleaning. Change my attitude. You can see how light it is. I can just lift it up with one hand. It looks really nice and light. I'm all done with this area. One of the first things I'm going to want to do is fill my feeders. This is what I call my community feeder. And let me get my brush and brush it off. I like to get this feeder cleaned up just a little bit because I'm not going to be able to get out here and clean it up much over the winter, so I like to at least give it a good brush off before winter comes. And this is the feed that goes in this community feeder. And if you see this little bluebird on the front here, when I came out to do this filling of the feeders, there was a bluebird that was just about to go to the feeder, and when I opened the door, it scared it away. And I'm like, shoot, I've been waiting for the bluebirds to come back, and here I had one. I guess he hasn't really left yet, and I scared it off. And I put a bit more feed in the feeder than I normally do in the summer and spring because I'm putting enough in here to kind of keep them coming. I don't have as many birds coming through the feeder now that many of them have left for the season. But I don't want to have to come out here every day either. And then in this feeder, I put this fruit nut blend that's specific for woodpeckers and other songbirds. It has fruit and nuts and other goodies in it.
And in case you're wondering, this one's called a squirrel in the box, and it looks pretty good. So I won't fill it just now, but the squirrel gets on here, opens it up, he can get in, get his head in, get any food out, and when he gets off, it closes up. So birds can't get in there, but squirrels can. Now my husband has already started some work out here. He's put away quite a few things, but the pots and things that he's not sure about what I want to do with, he's stacked up here on this table. Some of them will live under the table over the winter, some of them will go in the shed. So, but he has learned not to just pitch the pot or all the dirt that's in the pot, because sometimes I have things in the pot that I want to over and I need it to sit outside. So let me address that. And then the ones that I want him to put on the shed, I'll just sit over in a corner and then he'll take care of that and then focus on blowing off the rest of the patio once he's sure that I've got what I want done taken care of. I had to dig this little basket out of the trash and he's like, well, it's no good, it's old, but I like this basket. I like to put flowers in it. I put something in it every summer and spring and just kind of set it around outside somewhere, so I did not want this to get picked. This can go in the shed. This can go in the shed. So the things going in the shed, I'll just set aside for him. We get a lot of leaves dropped here in Indiana, especially this time of the year. I got a lot of trees in my backyard, so. I'm all done with what I have to do outside now. So my zone one stuff is done. I guess zone one and a little extra. So I put the things that I need him to put in the shed over there. He's got some other things out here that he'll finish up with, but I'm all done. So now he can finish up his task.
Thank you so much for joining me as I finish up zone one. I have really gotten some good work done. I am so glad that I discovered the Flylady. It's just been amazing the amount of work and the pockets of clean that I've been getting in my house. And I thought my house was already clean, but I'm taking things to a new level. And I am really pleased. And my husband notices, and even my son, who notices nothing, has also noticed. So I'm really glad that I found Flylady Cat and the Flylady Clean system. So, I hope you enjoyed this Clean With Me segment. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the subscribe button and hit that little bell icon so you don't miss any upcoming videos. I'm loving this Clean With Me series. I'm loving what I'm learning, and I hope I will inspire you to join me in making some changes in your home. In the meantime, your question for today is this. What part of today's Clean With Me did you like most? Inquiring minds want to know. And as always, please like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.